What's up? It's River, and today we're looking at the Fuji X-T30. Now, this is a really unique imaging system. I don't even want to call it a camera. I would call it an imaging system. This camera goes completely left field, what everybody in the market is doing right now. It's really, really, really unique. This camera does have crazy specs that actually blow its competition away, but it's not trying to compete with Sony and Canon. It's doing its own thing. So let's take a look at what exactly this camera does and what it can do for you. Let's get into it. So right off the bat, this camera packs a wallop. In this tiny little body is a 26.1 megapixel sensor that goes from 100 ISO to 12,800 ISO completely clean. And the noise in this camera is something unique and entirely on its own. Technically, there is no noise in this camera, but we'll get into that later. Fuji makes a photo camera, it absolutely delivers. The images from this camera are absolutely stunning. And they're not stunning because of the specs or some fancy feature. They're stunning because Fuji really took the time to hone the color science, the look of this camera. So when you take a photo with this camera, you're like, damn, that's a Fuji. Despite the small size, this is a very powerful photo camera. It does 8 frames per second with the mechanical shutter and 30 frames per second with the electronic shutter. That's faster than the 1DX Mark II in an $800 camera. That's kind of mind blowing. As for video, it does 120 frames per second with zero crop. It does 4K with a tiny, tiny, tiny crop, which I actually don't notice. Like, if someone had to tell me that there's a crop, I didn't notice it at all. It's that tiny. And here's the thing, for my tech heads out there, this camera shoots at 200 megabits per second. What that basically means is this camera gives you more data and more information in your videos than the Canon does, and more than what the A7S and the A6500 does. It only gives you 50 or 100. Canon only gives you 45 to 65. This camera gives you 200. That is insane for an $800 camera. It shoots video in all the standard speeds like 23, 30, 4K at 23 and 30, and does HD at 60 or 120. Has the option to give you the video as slow motion right out of the camera. Now here's the part that I'm really excited to talk about. Fuji was one of the original photography and film companies. They made the cameras, they made the film. They're pretty much masters of color science and the look of images. So this camera actually comes pre-built with Fuji film emulations, which pretty much means Fuji has license and patents for the way their film looks. Other companies cannot copy them. They have a license and a patent for that chemical process. And what Fuji has done is they've transferred that film process into a mathematical algorithm that is applied in camera to these images. So when you take a photo, it doesn't look exactly like Fujifilm, but it comes pretty damn close. So when you go through them, you're like, wow, these all look really good. And to get that look in camera without having to do post-processing, it really just brings you back to like the old school feel of 35 millimeter film, where you're like, I take the photo, it looks great, I have it, I develop it, great. And now it's even quicker because the emulation is built right into the camera. I've previously said that Canon photos all look good right out of the box. This camera takes what Canon does and cranks it up to 20. These photos not only look good right out of the box, but they look like they've been processed in Lightroom and developed already right out of the box. The main thing I want to communicate with you guys isn't the fact that this camera has really nice specs or this and that. What's really special about this camera is the fact that Fuji has given you all of their Fuji looks right in camera. So if you're somebody that's just like, I just really want to make myself look like art, just make it look like the crazy images I see on Instagram, and I don't really want to do all the Lightroom stuff, this is their in camera for you. It just makes it that much more fun to use this camera. Like, the autofocus is interesting because it's amazing for photo, really mediocre for video. With photo, I'm so confident with this camera. It's small and light, and there's so many times where I just like see something pretty, I just point this camera at it and I just click. And I'm so confident that it will be in focus and it will get exactly what I want in focus to be in focus. The autofocus for video in this camera isn't terrible. Like, it has phase auto detection across the entire sensor. So if you're shooting something where someone's just walking in front of your camera and you're on a gimbal, you'll be fine. If you're doing something where you're zooming in and out of someone's face, you'll be fine. For simple stuff where you're just kind of moving the camera and you don't want to pull focus yourself, just want the camera to kind of track for you, you will be totally fine. But when it comes to like fast paced stuff, we're just kind of whizzing around, shooting different things, it's not really gonna hold up. But with this camera, when it comes to video, I would rather pull focus myself. It's not a bad autofocusing system. It does the basic stuff, 80% of what you'll use it for, pretty well. But for that last 20, I would rather pull it myself. But if you're doing the kind of stuff where you can pull your own focus and you can meticulously plan out your shots, or if the focus stuff just isn't that complicated, this is a really good camera. I love the image out of it. So I've talked about how this is a really unique and interesting camera that diverts from what most of the market is doing. So what situations would this camera be good for? If you're the type of person that wants to take Polaroids, and you want to take Polaroids because you think Polaroids are cool, and you understand that there's like a unique thing about film, and there's like a different like vibe to like making really artsy work, this is a camera for you. If you just want to take photos that are on like a higher level and just like up your photo game, this is a camera for you. If you want to shoot models and high fashion, if you're like an amateur or like a working professional, this is a great camera. It's a really good studio camera. I would definitely, and I plan to, shoot my upcoming studio work with this camera. When it comes to video, I would really recommend this camera to anybody that wants to make cinematic stuff, personal work, or like travel work, because this camera is a really unique look and your work inherently will have a really unique look that will set it apart from everybody else. The only thing I wouldn't recommend this camera for is vlogging. This camera does not have a flip-up screen, nor does it have very good autofocus in video. It's just not gonna meet your needs. Vlogging is super fast-paced and like here, there, everywhere, and this camera is just not gonna be able to keep up with you. As for the build and feel of this camera is made to feel like and look like an old vintage film camera. It has these really clicky dials on it that I love playing with. The on and off button is actually one of my favorite things on this camera. Flip that button, you're just like, ooh, this camera's turning on. But this camera has a dial right up here that is solely made for your shutter speed. And I really like the feeling of just like looking down, seeing where my shutter speed at, and like kind of manually tweaking it like you would on an old film camera. One thing that I really appreciate about this camera is that almost every button and dial in this camera is customizable. So what I did was I made one dial for ISO, one dial for aperture. One of my big things with a lot of DSLRs is that they don't have the right shortcut buttons there. They don't have like everything quickly accessible. But with this camera, like I can customize it to like the way I want to use it. And for the quality of the build, it looks like metal, but obviously it's not metal. It's like a soft plastic. It's got like a rubber grip all the way around it. Despite being an $800 camera, it actually feels really premium. I feel like I'm using a $2,000 camera. It does not feel like it's gonna break apart on me. The hinge on the articulating screen feels really solid, and that's one of the first things I check in a camera. The dials don't feel mushy. The dials are really clicky. The buttons are really clicky. It just feels really, really good to use. In the past, I've said that I love using the touchscreens on the Canon. It just feels snappier and more like a 2019 experience for me. But if I had to compare using the buttons on this camera to the Canon cameras, these just feel way better. They're clicky. They all have like a solid to them. They don't feel mushy. The menus are really well laid out. I kind of wish Canon would take their tech and put it in a body like this. Canon cameras would be way better off. I say this time and time again, if you're looking for a low light monster, you must get a Sony. However, I actually like the look of this camera and low light better than the Sonys and the Canons. Why? This camera always has a really cinematic and like contrasty look to it. In low light, it does not show any significant grain all the way up to 12,800. The Canons are completely unusable after 6400. But this camera actually holds up pretty damn decently at 10,000 and 12,800 ISO. At 12,800 ISO, it probably applies some denoising, but it looks really good. And what I like about this camera is that if you look at the Sonys, they just get completely washed out. I don't have a Sony camera to compare right now, unfortunately. If you look at this camera, it looks really good at 12,800 ISO, and it actually doesn't get completely washed out. The Canons get too contrasty. The Sonys get too like bland and flat, but this camera looks good in low light and still has like a bit of contrast, and it still looks really cinematic in video. As for photos, I feel like you never really need to worry about noise because everything can be cleaned up in post. So yeah, this camera is really solid at 12,800 ISO. But this camera does a really, really good job, especially considering the fact that it's an $800 camera. I keep forgetting that this is an $800 camera. It really feels like a $2,000 or $3,000 camera. One thing that I want to make sure I mention is that this camera is very, very clean. Because of the sensor technology in this camera and the lack of pixel binning, there is almost never any noise. At 4,000, 5,000, 10,000 ISO, this camera is nearly noiseless. In fact, there's actually a mode in this camera that lets you noise reduce even further. And side note is that there's actually an option in camera to add film grain in camera to your images. Which is really funny because Fuji really wants you to like feel like your images feel and look like film rather than a digital JPEG. So who is this camera for? This camera is super affordable at $800. With a kit lens, you're looking at about $1,200 or $1,300. The camera isn't meant to be like a mom and pop camera where like, oh, I'll shoot my kid's birthday on the weekend or like a dance recital. It's really meant to empower people who want to make art, people who want to make really high-end images, people who really want to take their personal work and their professional work to a next level. With the film emulations built in, that unique Fuji look and that unique Fuji experience, it's really aimed at people who want to make content in a new and exciting way. Even if you already have a really badass Canon or really badass Sony, I really recommend picking this camera up and at least trying it, because the way you create with this camera is unlike the way you create with a Canon or Sony. And I promise you, you will see a massive jump up in your creativity and your ideas and the way your images come out by using this camera. Personally, for me, this will now be my main travel camera. I really like the idea of having all the film emulations built right into the camera, being able to share these photos right from the camera to my family and friends, to my Instagram. It already has the look dialed in. I really feel like that's the kind of travel camera I've been looking for. I personally feel like this is going to take my travel photos to the next level. Hey guys, thanks for watching. There's a link in the description below if you want to learn anything more about this camera. Also, feel free to leave a comment or question down below. I genuinely love interacting with every single one of you, and it's been a pleasure to answer your questions over the past few Canon videos. So if you have any questions at all, feel free to hit me up. And of course, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for future content. Until next time, guys.